or February of would you highlight first?
I mean, yeah, they change a lot of stuff, that's for sure. Yeah, I think too. It's a big factor too, because AD, Brown, like, played great, everything too, so. And, I think that, Russell, Beasley, like, Russell's a great point guard, but, like, great role player as well. One guy's like that, of course, that's make them a different team for sure.
Big part of LA's, any success LA's had defensively since you've been here is the ability to defend without fouling. Obviously, and some of them, they've leaned on to cover everybody, you know, centers. You saw that in playing against Cat. You see him pick up a full court and everything. You see you obviously guard the position at the wing. How do you feel like the Clippers can execute that defending without fouling against a team and like they've been getting to the free throw line that been currently not raised versus since the All-Star break?
I mean, yeah, we'd have to. I mean, that's what kind of goes through. Well, the fact we lost the last game against the Pelicans, so if you don't really like foul that much, the second quarter might be in a better shape to start selling that for maybe get that game, so you never know. So, yeah, tonight, especially tonight, it's going to be a high intensity game. Tense, not very physical on both teams, so call the factors and the big key, but we're gonna have to do a good job with that part for sure.
How do you see Austin Reeves' ability to get to the line? Like, I'm sure y'all have kind of looked at how he's a different player now than he was last year, probably a different player than he was to start this year as far as his ability to be efficient and get to the free throw line.
He has way more, probably more confidence, that's for sure. He's got the ball right in his hands, and I think just putting it works and it's good for them, I guess. But I try to limit his work for sure, because it's been a big key for them the last 2-3 weeks. We have a lot of success the last couple of weeks, but it's been a big key for them. So all the guys would have to sit down for sure.
Sorry if this was asked earlier, but do you see anything different in Russ like yesterday at practice just because this is his first time facing the Lakers?
No.
Do you worry about, he's always extra amped up for every game, but do you worry about him being a little extra today?
No. I mean, I wouldn't have that. The guy like a bit scared of, doesn't really show up. I mean, that's who he is, that's Russ though. He's going to be excited, maybe super excited for tonight. We know that, but he knows as well that we have 22. In this game, it's a big game for most of that, both of us, but most team, but we care about us now, so it's a big game for us. And he knows that. So we know he's gonna show up tonight and do what he can to make us win.
Is that something you guys will feed off of?
Yes, I guess.
I mean, it gives you guys extra juice.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, that energy, that keep rolling with night, so we're gonna follow that for sure.
I know that not everybody watches these games, but game in Utah last night, were you seeing any of it?
No.
You already seen it?
No. I mean, I didn't watch actually the last 5 minutes of the overtime game. I watched it replay, but
I was going to ask you, the Lakers have defended fairly well, part of what allows them to have that free throw advantage, the fact that they keep teams off the free throw line as well. Obviously, the Jets scored a lot of points, and just wanted to, where do you see that defense? Like, how do you analyze, how that team's performed well physically, but also, potential, areas of
they're very versatile on defense. This guy we can guard multiple positions as well, so, we have that part of the year, every team, really needs to win, so. See what happens tonight. We're gonna have a game plan. We try to, for sure, make more points than them tonight. That's the basic of basketball. But how are we gonna do it? We see what happens tonight.
Let's get ready for HoopJab.